Hi crocheters of the world! I'm Juana and this is Juana's Crochet Channel on YouTube. In this tutorial I want to show you how to crochet this top, summer top, that I created, so it's my design. And as for all of you that follow me, you know that I am trying to create patterns that are really, really easy to resize. So this one is, let's say, the same thing. So I tried to explain this project step by step in the so you can create it, you can work it in any kind of size you want to work it. It's really easy. I will work in this tutorial. I work with a medium worsted weight yarn and 4 millimeters hook, and I worked with two colors, as you can see, and two different texture, not texture, because there are two yarns that all of them are medium waist worsted weight yarn, but one is cotton and viscose and the other one is cotton, viscose and linen. So I think it's really, really nice. You can use any kind of medium worsted weight yarn you want, so cotton or cotton and viscose, or I don't know, cotton and silk, and there are so many variation of summer yarns. And that's all. So hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and please come let me know in the comments area that you like it. And if you like my tutorials, please don't forget to subscribe for other more. I'll let you to the tutorial now. Okay, crocheters of the world, now first I want to give you some information about this project. So how we begin it and how many chains we need and what is the measure that actually it's the important measure for our top to fit. Now we will begin here somewhere under the underarm, actually. Okay, so it's here, this is the line, and this is the measure that we need. So you have to measure yourself or for whom you want to make this top, summer top, and we will begin here and we will go on until we reach more or less the underarm, just straight, and then we will begin with some decreases here, as you can see. Hope you can see. I will just zoom in a little bit. So with some decreases here, and then we will go on straight again, but we will divide it here to create the neck line. Will be a square neck shape, neckline. Okay, so it's really, really easy. And we will continue on with the back side, the same thing. We will make the increases actually here, because you'll see, and we will get the same line with the back side too. So we will get here, we will be here, then we will cut the yarn and we'll continue with the bottom side. Okay, I will use for this another very important thing. So leave some ease here, so 1 or 2 centimeter on one centimeter actually on one side and another side when you measure yourself for ease. Of course, it's important, and You will need a chain of multiple, a foundation chain multiple of six. This is very important, multiple of six. Now, I'm working on this project with cotton and viscose yarn, medium weight, worsted weight yarn, and with a 4 mm hook. So you can use any kind of cotton yarn or cotton and viscose, cotton and linen. I don't know what kind of yarn combination you will find, but of course it must be a summer yarn, so must be something with cotton, of course not with wool. And okay, what else can I say? A medium yarn thickness yarn, okay, and I will work it with 4 mm hook. But of course if it is thicker or thinner than my yarn, there's no problem, because I just give you the measure that you need. So just to be sure that you will not go wrong, okay, with the size. Okay, now, so I begin my project with 72 chains. And if you don't know how to work the chainless double crochet beginning technique, there's no problem. You can begin like this if you know how to, but if you don't know, there's no problem. I will show you how to begin in order to leave a nice border, because from here actually we will have to work the bottom side, the bottom part of the summer top. So I have 72. Now I will begin with a chain of 3. So I want to chain 3 more. For the first double crochet will be this will be the first row will be a round. Yes, the first row will be a round. Okay, so the first row will be of double crochets only. Yarn over, and now count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and into the fifth, but on the back side. So we will work actually on the back side of our chain foundation, which means this is the front side where you can see we have two nice loops for a chain. As you can see, we have two loops. Okay, now if we turn our chain on the back side, we only have just one loop in the middle. This is the loop, and this is the loop where we will working in. Okay, so this popping up loop here, actually you can see it, it's really really easy, and it's here that we will work. Okay, now again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and into the fifth chain, yarn over, and into this loop. So we will work only on the back side of our here, only on the back side of our chain. Now this is the first, and this is the second. Okay, and we will just go on like this, working our double crochets into these nice back loops of the chain. Okay, so on the back side actually of the chain, more than back loops, is the back side of our chain. Oops, what I have here, yarn over, insert the hook. Yes, I know it's not very easy, but it's very important. So we have to just continue on working like this. So this is our little loop there on the back side where we have to work. So can you see it's here? We yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, and let's say that my yarn, it's a little bit strange, so it's not very easy to work with. That's why I am going on not very fast with it. Okay, so this is the loop, and just want to continue on. So I will have at the end of this row, I will have my 72 double crochet. So as you can see on the back side, on the bottom side, we will have actually the stitch as we have here. Okay, so it's exactly the same thing as you begin with the chainless double crochet, exactly the same effect. Okay, and this is what I want, because as I said before, we will want to continue on this part for the bottom part of the top, summer top, and it's very important. Okay, now I will continue on with this, and I will be back to show you how to begin the little pattern that I motif that I will work. So I will work the double crochet, the cross, crisscross, yes, double crochet, which is really really easy, and yes, that's all. So I finished my double crochet row, so the first one, then as you can see, I have the same thing here and here, so it's very important. Okay, now from the second row, we will go just straight until we reach the underarm, of course 1 or 2 centimeters under. We don't want to go very very so to go on to let for ease some 1 or 2 centimeters under arm, of course, and we'll work with the same crisscross double crochet. So I will show you how. So we will begin and end the row with a double crochet, which means the first it's a chain 3 for the double crochet. Now yarn over, and this is the first double crochet where we actually work the chain 3. Now we will skip the second double crochet and we will work into the third. And we work a double crochet. Now we yarn over, turn into the second double crochet, the one that we skipped, and work a double crochet too. And this is the crisscross double crochet. Now skip one double crochet, work into the next one double crochet. Now we yarn over, insert the hook into the double crochet that you skipped, and work a double crochet. Now yarn over and continue on actually like this. So skip one double crochet, insert the hook into the next, and work one double crochet. Yarn over, insert the hook into the double crochet that you skipped, and work one double crochet. And this is a crisscross double crochet. So we just go on like this. It's a really, really easy stitch to work, but it's not very airy, because actually I don't want it very airy, but it's something that it's not the double crochet. It's something else, and it looks really really nice from my point of view. So I will just continue on like this until the end of the row, and I will finish the row with a double crochet. And then I will begin the next row with a chain 3, then I will work my pairs of crisscross double crochets and finish the row with a double crochet. So that's all, we just have to go on like this. I tell you how long. So I told you how long. We just have to go on for, so the length actually, okay, better like this, the length that we need to complete working like this. Okay, so this is my crisscross, I don't invented it. Okay, this is a crisscross double crochet, and as I said, it's really, really nice and easy. Okay, now what I want is to, I will complete this section because it's really, really easy. We just go on straight, we don't have to increase, decrease, just go on. Okay, now I will complete this, and then I will be back to show you how to begin your increases and the rest of it. So I went on for 13 rows. And now I am ready to divide my front side of the top of the summer top into actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts. And the first part is this little part here. I put the markers. The first part is this little part here on one side and on the other at the beginning, at the end of the row. And this side is for the underarm. Okay. Now the other side, the other part, sorry, is this one from here to here. And this is for the tape of the summer top. This, which is the bigger one, is for the neck line. This one is for the other tape, and this one little one is for the other underarm. So 5 different parts. They are not actually different because 2 of them are the same of these 2. So this in the middle is for the neck line. Okay, now I will show you here. I draw a little bit. So it's this actually. This is the underarm. This is the tape. This is the neckline. The other tape and the other arm. Now, underarm, sorry. Now, I must say that it's really easy to divide because we are just have to think about the pairs of crisscrossed double crochets. So I don't want you to count the first and the last double crochet, just the pairs. Okay, now I have a total of 35 pairs of crisscrossed double crochets, and from these 35 I let 6 on one side and 6 on the other side, 3. There are 6 stitches, but 3 pairs, yes, of crisscrossed double crochets for the underarms. So on one side and the other side, and of course these 2 parts must be equally the same. Now for the tapes, I think there are tapes or stripes, or I don't know how to name it, hope to call them, hope that this is the right name. So for the tapes I put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 pairs, which means 18 stitches. Now in the middle here for the neck line, I leave 11 pairs, which is 22 stitches. And then of course the same number of pairs, which is 9, for the other tape. Okay, so that's all. You will just have to divide yours. Maybe you don't have the same number because you are working in a different size. So this is no problem. The important thing is you to understand how to divide it. Okay, now of course for the underarm we don't need many stitches to leave out. So yes, 6 to 8 stitches, there are actually, I think, just perfect for even for larger size. Okay, this is, let's say, a medium size. Okay, so from now on I will work only on one side. So actually here, because I have here the yarn, I will work only on one side. So I will work the tape and all my six, there are 6 plus 1 because it's the first stitch, and I will work these in decreases. So I will decrease this part, actually this one, and then of course this one too. But I will begin with this one because I want to work separately, of course not I want, I have to work separately the 2 tapes of the summer top. So it's something like this. So I will work this part first and then I will work this one exactly the same. Now I will show you how to decrease and how to go on with your tape. So I already worked one side, just want to show you here. I put in my first 6 rows I worked only on one side, and I work my decreases, and then I put 6 more rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yes, 6 more rows for the length that I need for the tape. Now I will show you how to work the this part with decreases on the other side, of course, and it's here. So I will insert my hook into my third chain, because this is my first double crochet, and I will only chain one, and I will skip it actually. Now here I have my first two, sorry, I want to zoom in. So here I have my first two double crochets of my first pair. I have three pairs here, okay, which means I will put three decreases in each of my second row. This is my first row of decrease. Now if you leave 8 or 10 pairs, you will put, of course, 4 or 5 decreases, but it's the same thing. Okay, now I will insert my hook into the first double crochet, and I will work a double crochet with, I don't want to finish it, yarn over, insert the hook into the second, work the double crochet but don't finish it, and close them together. Now work your two more pairs, two or three or I don't know how many, as I said, depends or on how many you have. I am only showing you this method of working a summer top, and I hope so it will be easy for you to understand. Now I will work nine pairs for the tape. I will put again the marker because I need it. Now I want to know how many stitches I have here left to decrease. Okay, and I want to go on and to work until I reach the other marker, so all my 9 pairs, and I will turn back. Okay, I will turn back, and into the next next row I will begin with another decrease. Okay, I'm back because I only want to show you how to begin another row with the crisscross stitch directly, because we don't have any more the double crochet on the beginning and at the end of the row. So I will chain two, turn my work, skip directly into the next, into the, oh, I don't need it anymore because now I know where to stop. Only for the first row of the tape I need, because now actually I know I only need this marker. Okay, so I said two chains, I skip into the second double crochet of the first pair and work a double crochet. Now directly into the first and work a double crochet. And this is how we work the crossed stitch to begin in the first pair of cross stitch. Okay, now I will just go on with this stitch, with this row. I won't increase at the end. So we only increase and decrease at the beginning of the each of our second row. Okay, so I will just go on with this, and I will be back to show you how to begin the third row, which is a row with decrease. So I finished the row, I worked the double crochet two, this one that is from the decrease, the last row decrease, and I have two pairs and one double crochet. Now I will chain one and turn. I will skip this double crochet, a work and work a decrease on this first pair. So one double crochet and two together, and work the last pair that you have, one and two crossed. Then of course work the pairs for the tape or for the I don't know what is it, stripe and brace maybe, yes, and turn back with a normal row. Then into the other one I will show you how to make the decrease again. So I finished the row and now I want to begin one more with a chain one, and my last decrease, which is my last pair here, so I won't work this double crochet, just skip it, insert the hook into the first double crochet of the pair, work it only, don't finish it, and the second one the same thing, and yarn over, pull through all. And now we have, I don't need anymore the marker because I know that the only thing I have left here, it's one double crochet that I will skip when I will begin the next row here. So actually I will finish this, work another one, and then I will be back to show you how to, and actually how to change color if you, I don't know, think you want to change color and to work like this as I worked in two colors. Actually I was afraid to run out of this yarn, so that's why I searched for something to fit with this yarn, and I have this two color combination which I like. So let me just finish this row, then I work one more from here to here, and then I will be back how to begin the last with this double crochet, so how to skip it, but I think it's more than obvious how. And okay, then I want to show you how to change color if you maybe want to change color. So I finished this row too, it's my 1 2 3 4 5 6 row, and now I will begin my seventh row. And I said I have here one more double crochet, so I will just chain one and skip this double crochet and work just my first pair of the brace of the tape, okay, and that's all. This is my seventh row and I want to finish it, and then I will be back to show you how to change color, because actually I want to change color and to continue on only with the brace pairs of stitches, so actually 9 pairs of stitches for 6 more rows. So I finished the row and I just want to chain one and to cut the yarn just to be sure that there is no chance to be undone. This is my, actually I'm all I am afraid about this changing color moment, okay, and that's why I like to just cut the yarn and make this nice knot. Now I insert the hook into the first stitch to join the new color, and I will leave the, I won't work the tails, I leave them here and later on I will sew them on this side, and then of course I will crochet a nice single crochet maybe around here for the neck line, so will be perfect. Now chain two and begin with the first pair. So that's why I wanted to show you. From my point of view, this is really really secure for the a secure way of changing yarn. Actually, when we work on this kind of long projects, okay, and we don't want them to be damaged by a tail that maybe we didn't secure well. Okay, now I just go on and work my six rows here, and I will begin my backside exactly the same thing as for the front side. So actually here it is, my front side, it's almost ready. I just want to, so here it is, it is almost ready. I just have to, okay, yes, I just have to finish this brace too, and I will be back to show you how to work the back side when I will finish with the 13 round rows, exactly the same thing that I worked here, okay. And I will begin exactly with 72 chains plus 3, and I will work the same double crochet first row and so on. So it's exactly the same thing. So I worked the 13 round rows for the back side, exactly the same thing that I worked for the front side. So actually it's this part, and now I have to work my six rows with the decreases. Only that on the back side we will decrease on the beginning and at the beginning and at the end of the row, of course, because we don't divide anything, we just go on and work all the row with one decrease at the beginning and one decrease at the end. I also put the markers because I have to decrease exactly the same number of stitches. So here they are, my stitches. There are three pairs of crossed double crochets on one side and three pairs of crossed double crochet on the other side. This means I have six stitches. I don't count the first and the last double crochet. Now let us begin. I will decrease for the beginning of the row. I will decrease exactly the same as for the front side. So chain one, skip the first double crochet and decrease, work a decrease on the first crossed pair of double crochets. Sorry, and this is my first decrease. Then I continue on with my next two pairs, and of course with the entire row, and at the end I will put another decrease. Now for that decrease I will be back to show you how to work, because on the front side we always worked the decrease only at the beginning of the row. So now for the back side we have to finish the row with a decrease too. So I will work all the row here and I will be back to show you how to decrease at the end of this row. Okay, so I am at the end of the row and now I want to put another decrease. So I worked my first two pairs of cross stitches, and here is my last, and here is where I want to decrease this last pair. So I reinsert the hook into my first one, work a double crochet, leave the loop on the hook, and into the next, the same thing. Yarn over, pull through all, decrease, made. Now we will just insert the hook into the chain 3, third chain of the beginning chain 3, pull up a loop and slip stitch. Now to begin another row, this will be the second row, so you know, into the second row we just go on and work the stitches as they are. We already know that we decrease in each of our second row as we did for the front side, only that we decrease at the beginning and at the end. So I turn my work and I want to begin with my double crochet here from the decrease made. Okay, so I insert a hook actually in this double crochet and I slip stitch. Now I am into it and I will chain 3 for the double crochet and work my pairs, two pairs, remaining two pairs of crossed stitches, 1 and 2. And I just want to go on like this, working all the stitches as they are for this row. Okay, now to finish the decrease part, you will just have to repeat these two rows for 6 times because I only have 6 stitches here, okay, left. But if you want to put more stitches for the underarm, maybe 8, as I said before, when we work the decrease part of the front side, you can put 8 and you will have 4 decrease to make in each of your second row. So the idea is that we have to make the same thing, exactly the same thing for the back side, only that we work the row, the entire row, not only one brace on at the time. Okay, so this is actually the difference, but from the bottom up, because this is actually a bottom up technique, we just have to go on and to work the decreases as we work them on the front side, exactly the same thing. Okay, for the brace here, for the sleeve actually, how can I say. Okay, so I will go on with my decreases here part and I will be back to show you how to continue on. So I finished the decreases part, the decreases rows, and as you can see, it's exactly the same, it's exactly the same thing that I have for the front side. And now I just want to go on, I put here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 rows more for the braces. So I will go on working 7 rows more, of course, entire rows for the back side. But actually not 7, only 6, because into the last I will just want to show you how to create a nice neckline on the backside too. So let me just finish my 6 rows, working exactly the same stitches, now it's just easy, and I will show you how to create the neckline and what stitch I choose for the bottom part of our summer top. So I finished my 6 rows, now I just, on the back side, now I just want to refresh your memory about the braces and the front side, neck line of the front side. So we have 9 pairs here, 11 pairs here and 9 here, and which means it's 18 stitches, 18 stitches and 22 stitches. Now on the back side we must have all these total of stitches, so all this amount of stitches, so we must have 18 plus 22 plus 18. Okay, this is the idea. Now I worked all my 6 rows and into the last row, my 7th, I just want to, as I said before, to make a little nice neck line on the back side too. So I will begin working my 18 stitches, then I will cut the yarn, I will skip the neckline, actually the 22 stitches, and I will continue with the last part of 18 stitches. That's all. So actually the same thing as the braces, okay, for the last row. Okay, now let me work this row, last row, and then I will be back to show you how to continue on. So how to put the borders and the bottom part here, the stitch that I choose for the bottom part. So I finished this part, my 9 stitches, my 9 pairs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and I have my 9 pairs here. So take the front side and the back side and don't cut the yarn when you finish this part. Just chain 1, turn your work and begin to join these two parts. And then you will do the same thing on the other side of the back side. So one loop, only back loops, okay, of the stitches, one back loop and the other, and slip stitch, okay, and now again back loop and back loop and slip stitch, okay, back loop, back loop and slip stitch. So at the end of this you will have the joining part on the top actually ready, two, not only the two parts, but okay, so just slip stitch, okay, so can you see it's really perfect. So I actually finished my summer top, but don't worry, I will explain step by step actually all that I work off the camera. Worked off the camera, it's not a big deal. That's why actually I prefer to work off the camera and then to explain all the steps, then to work and show you, and maybe lost lots of time just with very, very easy explanations. Now, first of all, of course, I just sew the parts together, and this is obvious, and I let free for the hands here, for the arms here, of course. Now, on the border, on each sleeve, let's say sleeve, I just put a single crochet little border here, working with the same size crochet hook. So mine was 4 millimeters. I just put in each, around each of my last double crochet of each of my row, I worked 2 single crochets, and this is the rule, okay? So 2 single crochets around each of your double crochet, which means that you will have double number of your single crochets for the number, real number of your rows of double crochets. So actually let me give you an example. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, so for my this part I have 9 rows of single of double crochets. This means that my border on my border I put 18. So double, okay, and that's it. This is the rule, and it's really, really easy to follow it. Okay, now for the neck line, actually it's really, really easy because I just began here on the back side, middle back side, and I went on with the single crochet. But when, so we have actually 4, these are the 4 places to put, where to put decreases. So actually I decreased like this. Last from here, from the back side, and the first from the right side. Okay, front side, right. Okay. Then here, one, the last one here, and the first one on this side. The last one on this side and the first one on this side. So actually, these are the four places to decrease, just to obtain something more round a little bit, okay? Not very square, but if you want it square, just go on and work. Now, you can work, you can work this with maybe a 3.5 millimeters hook, but I work all these borders with 4 millimeters hook, so the hook that I work all my project, and it's just perfect. Okay, and now another thing, not another, so this is for the upper part of the top. Now then, actually, I worked from here, can you see, this is my first, was my first round when I began my upper part. Now from here I work another round of double crochets, and you know we began as to continue with the bottom part, so I continued with the bottom part, and when I change color here, I change hook size too, because I actually didn't want to increase anymore. For me it was just perfect, because if you remember, we began with the chest circumference, actually circumference it's more or less, because we began with half of the circumference, and that gives us a perfect fit for all of our summer top, okay? So I don't think you have to increase. So I just changed the number of the size of my crochet hook from 4 millimeters to 4.5 millimeters, so only a half measure, okay? And then I continue on and I put this border. This is our arches and shells stitch. You will have the link incorporated into the tutorial and below this tutorial, so you can find it. Don't worry. And I only work two rounds of it. Okay, now you know that it's a multiple of 16, and when you work in round, you won't add the two chains more. So in the tutorial I said it's multiple of 16 plus two chains, but this is for working in rows. Now when we work in round, we just work 16, okay? We slip stitch to join, and we continue on, beginning with the first group of three double crochets. So this is, of course, we begin with the chain three, chain five, and then the second row will be with this. We'll begin with three double crochets into the single crochet. So you begin with single crochet, chain three, and you go on with your actually arches here, with your spaces, chain 3 and chain 5 spaces, you know, of the first row, and then into the second, into the first single crochet, you begin with this. You won't have the two double crochets at the beginning and at the end of the row. Of course, you will have the plain, actually, group of three double crochets. Okay, so that's it. Because it's a another thing, because it is multiple of 16, maybe I had exactly the number, so I was really really happy that actually it's 72. Do you remember I began with 72 on front side, so 72 on the back side of my top, so this is 144 stitches. And 144, fortunately, it's a multiple of 16, so I was really, really fortunate. Now, I had luck, sorry. But if you don't have a number that is multiple of 16, don't worry, just put some increases here and there to obtain the 16 multiple. And then, or you can choose any kind of lacy stitch pattern that you want, just to complete your summer top. Okay, so that's it. Hope you enjoy this tutorial. Hope you enjoy my pattern. And hope you find it easy to work. And nothing, just subscribe if you like my tutorials, and if you like some, if you want to see some more of my projects. And don't forget, yes, to subscribe and to rate, of course. Now, see you at the next tutorial. Bye-bye.